price from different browsers too. Okay. So now, if I want to download from Firefox, if I want to download from Firefox, okay, I will get this kind of screen. So let's say this is the Firefox window opened by Selenium Webdriver script. So I'll open up the Firefox browser from here. Okay, so I'll just cancel it. If I want to download, let's say I want to download something for this particular website called www.filehippo.com. So I want to download, let's say, browser. I want to download the Opera browser, for example. This is the Opera browser. So if I click on the download link for Opera in Firefox, the following window opens. So this is the page, and then I have to click on this particular link again called download latest version. So if I click out here, the following window actually is going to open, and we'll see this. Sorry for the music. This is the window which opens, and then you can click on the save button. It will save it on the downloads folder of your computer. Okay, this is how it opens. You can do download through the Firefox browser. The same download, when it happens through the Chrome browser, I'll go to the same website, filehippo.com. The download is a bit different. Let's say I want to go to browsers, and I want to go and download Opera browser and click on out here. Click on this particular link. And if we see that, it automatically downloads the exe. It does not open any window which asks me to save that particular file to a particular location in a disk. It directly downloads it. So these can be of downloads, can be down, or these kind of operations can be made to happen using Selenium Webdriver script if we have a window web component. For example, in Chrome browser, I can directly use the Selenium Webdriver script to click on the web component, because I just kept on clicking on the web component. But if I want to download the same stuff in Firefox browser, okay, let's say I want to download this particular browser, this window opens precisely. So I can click on this particular link, this window opens. Don't bother about the music. So this window opens, and this Windows can activity, or rather this window has Windows component. Save file as a Windows component, cancel as a Windows component. I cannot use Selenium Webdriver script. So for download with this kind of window in Firefox browser, I can use AutoIT. So I have to use a combination of AutoIT script and Selenium Webdriver script in order to download a particular file in Firefox browser. But if I do the same step in Chrome browser, it downloads directly without asking me to save it in a particular location. It directly downloads the exe. So in downloading files from the Chrome browser, I don't need to use AutoIT script. I can directly use the Selenium Webdriver script. But yes, download is also possible in Firefox by using the Firefox profile class. Okay, where I can avoid this particular window. So when I use the Firefox profile class, I can avoid this particular window. this particular window which asks me to save a file or which asks me to cancel. I can completely avoid this particular window while I download a particular file in Firefox browser using the Firefox profile class. So let's go back to the PPT out here. It says that there is a component called as browser.unload.folderList. This component is a preference in Firefox about config interface, which allows the user to choose between one of the three pre-specified location in which to store the downloads. So if I open up about.config in Firefox browser, let's open up the Firefox browser. Okay, let's cancel this. Let's open up about.config. Click on enter. I accept the risk. So in the search box, just write down folder list. Now the folder list is set to 1. If you see, like, the value of it is set to 1. The values that can be set to this particular preference called as browser.download.folderList can be 0, 1 or 2. 0 means it will directly save in the desktop. 1 means it will save to the download folder of the Windows machine. 2 means it will save to the specified location. Okay, let's go back to the value being 2. So if we are using the value as 2, the location specified for the most recent download is utilized. Now if you are using value number 2 for this particular preference, okay, what we need to use is a extra code, which is nothing but this particular code, profile.setPreference, browser.download.directory and path where you want to save it. Okay, so we'll see that. And there's also one component out here which will allow me to avoid this particular window. So there's a window which opens, right? So if I open up, if I want to actually, let's say, download in Firefox browser by clicking on this particular link, a window opens. Okay, let's close this particular music. I can avoid this window. For avoiding this window, there's a preference in about config. Okay, that preference is called as, I'll cancel this, rather, that preference is called as never ask. Okay, there's a preference called browser.helperapp.neverask.saveToDisk. Okay, so if I use this particular preference, I can avoid this particular window. And I have to use this preference with Firefox profile class. So let's download this particular Opera browser.exe file using the Firefox profile class. Okay, so let's go back to our script. I will create a new class called as download using Firefox profile. Call the main method. So what I intend to do is that I can use the same script to open up the Firefox browser. Okay, before I open up, I have to set the Firefox profile class. So I'll create an object of the Firefox profile class, call this as profile, okay, equal to new Firefox profile. We can import this particular class. And after that, we can use a method of the Firefox profile class called the setPreference method. So profile.setPreference. And there will be a key and a value. And the key value will be in string arguments. So the key will be nothing but this particular key. So if I go to about config, I want to avoid this particular window. So what I need to do is that I have to use this particular key, copy this particular key. Okay, let's say what is being getting copied. So this is getting copied, fine. Okay, and the value will be what kind of file I want to download. So I have to give the meme type. Okay, now for example, I want to download the exe file, so I have to give a meme type, and I've defined in the PPT where will you get the meme types. You can get it in this particular URL. So I can just copy this URL and I'll show you the meme types out here. So copy and let's say paste it. I'll close this particular part or this particular windows. Okay. So I want to actually download an exe file. So what is the meme type of exe file? So we need to first find out the .exe extension. The meme type is this. You can just copy this and go to the set preference method. We have given this particular preference of never to ask to save to the disk. This will avoid that particular window, the window which comes out here in the Firefox browser. Okay, so in the meme type value part, we can give that I want to download the exe file, and for downloading the exe file, this is the meme type, and it will not ask for saving to a disk. If I want to download, let's say, a Word document, I need to find out what is the meme type of Word document. So Word has an extension of .docs or .doc. .doc will have this particular meme type. So if I want to download Word, okay, I can copy this meme type, and let's say I want to avoid that particular window or which comes out in Firefox browser, I can just give the meme type of Word out here. It will download Word without asking you to save it to a particular disk location. So that window will be avoided by setting this preference. So I want to actually download exe right now. I'll do typing. So this is a meme type for your exe download, which will not allow ask me, which will rather avoid that particular window which asked us to save it to a particular location in a disk. Other meme types are also present out here. We can just check it out. Let's say you want to download a PDF file. So we will get the meme type for PDF. You want to download a .java extension file. This is the meme type for .java. You can use this and this both. If you want to download a JPG file, which is an image file, this is the meme type for JPG. You can use this and this together. Okay, so you can look at the other meme type for other kind of extension files. Since I am downloading an exe file, this is the meme type. So this will actually not ask for that particular window. It will avoid that particular window which asks me to save to a particular location in a disk. So you have to set preference like this. Now where will it get saved? If that is the question about config, you need to go and just write down folder list. So it is set value to 1. So it will basically be get saved in the download folder of the Windows machine. If it is set to 0, it will download directly in the desktop. If it is set to 2, it will download in the location in which you want to download it. You have to specify the path of that particular location. And for if you are setting it to 2, the extra code that you need to write down is this particular set of code that you see out here. So what you need to do, you just have to copy this and paste it out. Out here. That's all. Since it is set to 1 right now, if you can see that it is set to 1, it will download it in the downloads folder of the Windows machine. Okay. So what I can do is that I can pass this Firefox profile in the object of the Firefox driver. So just pass on this particular profile, which is referenced by the profile reference variable of the Firefox profile object. After doing that, I can navigate to this particular URL. The URL is you can directly go to this particular URL, download Opera. And so I need to use driver dot get method to navigate to that URL directly. Just choose to copy this. Now after navigating, so it opens up this particular page. Let me check it out first. Okay. So if I give that particular URL, it opens up this page directly. Okay, then I need to click on this particular link. So for clicking on this particular link, I need to use the Firebug to get the XPath of that particular link. So get the XPath of this particular link. So this is the XPath, and just copy it. Go back to my script on Opera link. So driver dot find element by the XPath expression is this, and we need to use the dot click method. Okay, and it starts downloading. That is what it's supposed to do. So what I'm going to do is that I'm going to run this particular class file. So this is one way of downloading files using the Firefox profile concept. So let's run this particular class file, and then we'd like to see what happens. It navigates to that particular URL. It should then click on that particular link. And we gotta have some patience. Should click on the link. And that will open up that trigger. So that window will be avoided by Firefox profile class now. And it should save the file directly on the downloads folder of the Windows machine. You see the download is happening. So if you see how the download is happening, and it has avoided to open up that particular Windows pop-up which asked me to save the file to a particular disk location. It downloadly saves it in the download folder of the Windows machine. Okay, so you can just check up, it got downloaded in the downloads folder. This is the downloads folder of the Windows machine, and the file is Opera. So you can just look at the Opera file. This is what it has got downloaded. Okay, so this is how you can download using the Firefox profile class. The other way to download is actually to use the auto ID tool. You need to create a different script of auto IT with Selenium Webdriver script in order to download files in Firefox or in Chrome, because in Chrome that particular window does not open, which asks me to save the file to a particular disk location, but in Firefox it opens up. So in Chrome you don't need to use AutoIT for downloading, because everything is a web component when you download files through Chrome browser. But when you use Firefox browser, that particular window opens, the window which has Windows component. So you need to create a script which will be a combination of AutoIT and Selenium Webdriver script. Okay, so that's about how to download files. Next, we are going to see the tool called SecuLy. Now, SecuLy is a tool